What is going on, guys? It's Waffle here. Welcome back to some more Skyrim Remastered Edition. Now, last time we left off, we were talking to the Greybeards, actually the, I guess you could call them somewhat the leader of the Greybeards, even though Parthenax is the leader. We're talking to Arengar over here, trying to convince him to be, I guess, the mediator between, General Tullius and, what was his name? The other guy. Jarl, not Balgriff, because that's the Jarl of Whiterun. Whoever the Jarl of Windhelm is that it? I forgot what it is. Or Winterhold? Which one is it? Is this one, isn't it? Yeah, Windhelm. Okay, yeah. We need to go to Windhelm now and talk to the Jarl there and be like, hey, we really need this peace treaty so that we can, you know, capture a casual dragon at the Dragon's Reach so I can go find where Alduin is. Oh, what is it, Lydia? This place smell like trash? Because I smell it. It smells like trash. Let's go back to the Jarl's quarters. I think it's back here, isn't it? Yeah, this big old tower in the back of Wind. Man, this place looks like garbage. It's like broken stones and dirt everywhere. Look at that. Ugh. Is no one going to fix that? Just leaving that out in the open like that. Oh, you going to talk to me about the the Dawn Guard or something, I bet?
All right. They're reforming the
Dawn
Guard.
Yep, he is. Just like that. Let's go inside the Palace of the Kings.
Give us a straight answer.
He's a true Nord. He'll come around.
I do the cooking and cleaning around the palace.
Oh, you must be the chef.
Couriers from Solitude.
Oh, that's not
the
him.
The Empire's putting a great deal of pressure on Whiterun.
And what would you have me do?
If he's not with us, he's against us.
He's trapped there now.
They all know that.
How long are you going to wait?
He's trapped. Good job there, Lydia.
I'm not sure you belong here, friend.
Oh my god, he teleported. Okay. Jarl.
Only the foolish or the courageous approach a Jarl without summons. Do I know you?
Well, technically you approach me, but whatever. I believe we've already met. Yeah, I was at Helgen.
Is that so? Yes. You were with us at Helgen. Destined for the chopping block, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, well, can we take this...
Be careful out
there. Let's go this way. Come on. Okay, can we talk now?
As you can see, I have much that requires my attention. If you're inclined to gab, there are some nice prison guards you may like to meet.
Well, I'll set free. I could have gone anywhere, but I came here to fight the Empire. No, not really. Maybe I can convince him. Maybe I can trick him. Is that what I'm going to do? I think it is. I'm going to trick him to talk to Jarl Balgriff about a peace treaty.
A fair point. Well... You've come to the right place, then. Speak with Galmar. I'm always looking for able fighters. Not everyone can say they made it out of Helgen. Seems we're all branded villains these days. So long as your criminal past stays in the past, and you fight for me with honor and integrity, we'll welcome you into our ranks. He knows that. They all know that.
How long are you going to wait?
Okay, sounds like trash. Get out of the way, Lydia. I think they're trying to, like, meet up with each other, but you're like, there you go, Lydia. Nice teleporting. Alright, well, I guess I still have to talk to him?
Speak with Galmar. He'll size you up and see where we can best use your talents.
Yeah, I'll talk to him later about this whole fake joining the Stormcloaks thing. I'm not 100% sure if I even want to join me, and I still haven't decided. Anyways, at Helgen, they said that you shouted the king to death. Ooh. Oh yeah, this is him, isn't it? Why are you fighting this war? Why'd you kill the High King? Man, there's so many questions I can give him. I have a message from the Greybeard. Yeah, let's do this one first. And then I guess we can ask him these other things, right?
It's about time they turned their gaze from the heavens back to our bleeding homeland. What do they want?
They want to negotiate a truce until the dragon menace is dealt with.
I have the greatest respect for the Greybeards, of course. And the dragon attacks are a growing plague. But the political situation is still delicate. Not all the Jarls are fully committed to supporting me as High King. I can't afford to appear weak. I can't agree to this unless Tullius himself will be there.
Politics be damned. Alduin has returned. General Tullius hasn't agreed yet. Oh man, I should have talked to him first, shouldn't I? Let's see. Still need to go to Solitude to talk to General Tullius. Should we do that now or should I try and persuade him? If I tell him General Tullius hasn't agreed just yet, he's going to be like, oh, I won't go unless he agrees first. And then I bet I'm going to go to Solitude and talk to General Tullius. He'd be like, oh, I'm not going to go until Jarl Ulfric agrees first. It's going to be like an endless loop, I bet, right? So, I don't know, should we try and persuade him or should we just go talk to General Tullius first? Let's try and persuade him. Might as well, right? I doubt we're going to get anything done. If anything, do we have anything that helps with speech right now? Let's check our inventory real quick. I think we did, didn't we? We picked up something. Oh, I think I put it up, yeah. Okay.
I need to send Bolgruff a stronger message.
Yeah, whatever. Blah, blah, blah. How goes the war? Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, what about the Greybeards thing? Let's do this one. There you go.
I have the great...
Yeah. Let's try and persuade him. There you go.
I can't afford to appear weak. I can't agree to this unless Tullius himself will be there.
Okay, yeah, well, politics be damned. Alduin has returned. Let's try and persuade him.
Alduin, the world eater of song and legend.
Yep.
If that's true, we're all doomed anyway. And if it isn't true, well, then the fight to free Skyrim goes on. Either way, I don't see the use in talking to the Empire.
Alright, well, the Greybeards won't let the Empire take advantage of you. Tullius will look weak if he refuses, not you. That guy back there is dancing. Let's do the first one. The Greybeards won't let the Empire take advantage of you.
You speak truly, Dragonborn. Sometimes the grubby business of politics clouds my eyes. Besides, it will be good to see High Hrothgar again.
Alright, so you'll come to the Peace Council or what? That guy's still dancing. You're not, like, stuck on anything. What are you doing?
Yes. I'll give Tullius one more chance to quit Skyrim with his tail between his legs.
If by message you mean shoving a sword through his gullet.
Dork.
Taking his city and leaving him in disgrace would make a more powerful statement, don't you think?
So we're ready to start this war in earnest then.
Soon.
We'll show those
faithful dogs to this land. I still say you should take them all out like you did dead King Torig.
Torig was merely a message to the other Jarls. Whoever we replace them with will need the support of our armies.
We're ready when you are.
Things hinge on Whiterun. If we can take the city without bloodshed, all the better. But if not...
Okay, well, I guess that's the end of that conversation. I guess he's going now. We don't need to talk to General Tullius first. Now I guess we can go talk to General Tullius. I think I might have confused General Tullius with whoever the... I forgot. Whatever the leader of the Whiterun Guard Army thing is. Forgot what his name was. Anyways, General Tullius, we need to head to Solitude. Let's go to Solitude and try and talk to him and try and convince him to come to the Peace Council. If we can, then that means, like, I guess all three major people that we really want to be here, you know. General Tullius, Jarl Stormcloak of Windhelm, and, of course, Jarl Balgriff is going now that we're going, hopefully.
Gold for a veteran?
You know what? Might as well. Might as well. You might be lying, but you do have, like, one pupil, so, like, it might as well.
Can you spare a septum? Lost an eye during the Great War, or I'd earn it myself.
Well, what's your story, old man?
I was the finest scout in the Legion once. Tracked down all the places in the wilds that were causing people trouble. Lost my helmet in one of the old caves. My pretty, pretty helmet. Life just got worse after that. Kept losing things. So many things.
Might be able to find that lucky helmet. Yeah, what if I could find that helmet for you?
Oh, you could? I sure would love to have it again. Could show you some of my old scouting tricks.
Huh. Scouting tricks? That could be helpful, huh? Find Noster's helmet inside Shadow Green Cavern. Alright, let's go there. Let's give him a little bit of gold right now. Might as well, right? Veteran, after all, might as well pay our respects.
Oh, thank you. Divines bless your kind heart.
Yep. Were you really in the army? Meh. I'm like, he does have one eye, so I can only imagine he actually was, wasn't he? Unless he shot it out with, like, an arrow or something.
What? You see a man fallen on hard times, and you think he's been like that forever? I was there. I fought in the Great War. I was on the field at Anvil. And when I was struck down, they left me. You understand? They left me for dead. I didn't leave them.
That's savage. All right. Turn to turn to General Tullius. I don't know where he's at. Is he up? Is this the... I think it is. This is the blacksmith thing, though. Is this also, like, an entrance to the... I guess it is. Yeah, okay. Let's go over here. Talk to him in the guard area or whatever. So, castle door. Yeah, whatever about these vampires. I'll kill him here pretty soon. Jeez, give me some time.
They say the college has been snooping around Sorthal. Mages in a burial crypt. No good can come of that.
Yeah, tell me about it. Talking to ghosts.
Ulfric's planning an attack on Whiterun.
Bloody good blacksmith.
He'd be insane to try.
Keep an eye out for trouble.
That's not what my scouts report, sir. Every day more join his cause. Riften, Dawnstar, and Winterhold support him.
It's not a cause. It's a rebellion.
Call it whatever you like, General. The man's going to try to take Whiterun.
Jarl Balgruuf.
Balgruuf refuses the Legion's right to garrison troops in his city. On the other hand, he also refuses to acknowledge Ulfric's claim.
Well, if he wants to stand outside the protection of the Empire, fine. Let Ulfric pillage his city.
General.
Keep an eye out for trouble. It's only a matter of time.
Sir? You can't force a Nord to accept help he hasn't asked for.
If Ulfric's making a move for Whiterun, then we need to be there to stop him. Draft another letter with the usual platitudes, but this time share some of your intelligence regarding Ulfric's plans. Embellish if you have to. We'll let it seem like it's his idea.
Yes, sir.
You Nords and your bloody sense of honor.
Don't.
Sir.
Let's talk to him. It seems like he's done talking to her.
I remember you. You were at Helgen. Speak to Legate Rikka. I suspect we could use someone like you.
So we could trick both of the people, both the Legion and the Stormcloaks. Anyways, yes, sir, that's not why I'm here. Let's leave both doors open. I'm like, we've already technically told Ulfric Stormcloak that we're going to join him or whatever, so might as well, right?
Good.
Well, is that okay? Well, whatever.
Speak with Legate Rikka. She will determine if you are Legion material.
Yeah, whatever. I have a message from the Greybeards.
The Greybeards? What do those old hermits want with me?
Oh, what a savage. They're convening a peace council at High Hrothgar.
Why, there's nothing to discuss as long as that traitor Ulfric is in arms against his rightful emperor.
We need a truce until the dragon menace is dealt with.
They are getting to be a problem. But I wasn't sent to Skyrim to fight dragons. My job is to quell this rebellion, and I intend to do just that, dragons or no dragons.
Well, dragons are the bigger problem than the Stormcloaks right now. Best time to negotiate is from a position of strength. Ulfric has already agreed to attend. I couldn't tell him that. That's completely and utterly true. Maybe he'll attend if Ulfric's already attending, or maybe he's going to be like, I don't want to go if Ulfric's going there, I don't know. What should we do? Dragons are a bigger problem. Let's try and persuade him first.
I'll be the judge of that. Besides, by all reports, the Stormcloaks are suffering just as much as we are from these dragon attacks.
What the best time to negotiate is from a position of strength. We did just say that they're getting attacked as much as Stormcloaks, so let's tell him Ulfric has agreed to attend the Peace Council.
Has he? I suppose he doesn't want to miss a chance to bluster about the Empire's many crimes. He's probably hoping I'll refuse so he can blame the Empire for being unreasonable. I think I'll have to disappoint him yet again.
Nice. So you'll come into the Peace Council then, huh?
Yes, fine. I'll come to this Greybeard Council. For all the good it will do.
Alright, sounds good. Now I need to turn to Ungar. Well, who do I have to turn to about joining the Legion? Probably not her. Wait, yeah, I guess it is her, right? I guess I don't have that mission selected just yet, huh? Alright, let's head out of here. Skiddle down. I'm going to get out of here first! First!
Greybeards have called a peace council at High Hrothgar. Can you believe it?
Yeah, I was the one literally that came here and told you guys about it, invited you. Jeez, what an idiot. Let's leave. Oh yeah, we still have like a bunch of like weird missions to do here, like something about some hip bone that we need to go like go into the Blue Palace or something crazy like that. I don't know. Alright, well, let's go fast travel back to High Hrothgar, about this. Be like, hey, General Tullius and Ulfric Stormcloak have both agreed to come to the Peace Council. Alright. Let's see if they're gonna come and smoke the peace pipe. 420 blazed hater! Let's go up to High Hrothgar as it snows and flurries upon the mountaintop. Oh yeah, he's actually hanging out inside here. Nice. Well, looks like they're all here. Well, all except for one. There's only three out of the four here. Hey there, Hrothgar.
So, you've done it. The men of violence are gathered here in these halls whose very stones are dedicated to peace. I should not have agreed to host this council. The Greybeards have no business involving ourselves in such matters.
Don't worry, I get them to agree to peace. This was the only way to get Balgruuf's help. Now let's do this first one.
Peace? I doubt it.
Yeah.
They may put their weapons down for a moment, but only to gather strength for the next bloodletting. They are not yet tired of war. Far from it. Do you know the ancient Nord word for war? Season unending. And so it has proved. But regrets are pointless. Here we are. Take your seat at the council table, and let us see what wisdom we can find among these warriors of Skyrim.
Alright, well, let's go to the Peace Council. I assume it's already going on. I thought it was going to happen in the future, but I guess they already just... Wait, where are we going? This way? I guess they are already started the Peace Council, like, immediately, huh? Delphine is here?
You know why we're here.
Oh, she's in here, isn't she?
Let us in or not.
No, she's over there, I guess.
You're not invited here. You're not welcome here.
Oh. They just said, you're not invited here, Delphine, but you're going to hang out here anyways. Whatever, let me sit down. Oh, look at that, we got a bunch of people here. More just General Tullius and Ulfric Stormcloak and Yarabalgruf. I might as well take a seat. I'm the first one to sit down. Anyone else going to sit down? There's Lydia back there, just kind of hanging out. I guess we're waiting for the Grey Fellows. Are they going to sit at the table, or are they just going to, like, sit in the corners or whatever they're doing here? Well, it's kind of weird. I'm the only one sitting down. Is anyone else going to sit down? Because this is kind of strange for me.
Now that everyone is here, please take your seats so we can begin.
I guess I sat down a little earlier.
I hope that we have all come
no.
here in the spirit
you
of-
You insult us by bringing her to this negotiation? Your chief Talos Hunter?
That didn't take long.
Diplomat.
Hear, hear.
I have every right to be at this negotiation. I need to ensure that nothing is agreed to here that violates the terms of the White Gold Concordat.
She's part of the Imperial delegation. You can't dictate who I bring to this council.
Please, if we have to negotiate the terms of the negotiation, we will never get anywhere. Perhaps this would be a good time to get the Dragonborn's input on this matter.
By Ysmir's beard, the nerve of those Imperial bastards, eh? To think that I would sit down at the same table with that Thalmor bitch. Either she walks or I do.
You're right. The Thalmor have no business here. What's the harm? Besides, Tullius doesn't really want her here either. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what to do. I don't know why Elowen is here in the first place. I were rid of her in the, like, 20 episodes ago, but whatever. You're right. The Thalmor have no business here. What's the harm? Besides, Tullius doesn't really want her here. I don't know. You know what? Get her out of here. The Thalmor have no business here. Forget about them.
I'm glad we agree on this.
Very well, Ulfric. Enjoy your petty victory. The Thalmor will treat with whatever government rules Skyrim. We would not think of interfering in your civil war.
Ha! Skyrim will never bow to the Thalmor. Unlike your Imperial friends here.
Old drama.
You're lucky I respect the Greybeard's council, Galmar.
Legate, we represent the Emperor here.
Sorry, sir. It won't happen again.
Now that that's settled, may we proceed?
I have something to say first.
Here we go.
The only reason I agreed to attend this council was to deal with the dragon menace. There's nothing else to talk about. Unless the Empire is finally ready to renounce its unjust claim to rule over the free people of Skyrim.
I knew he wouldn't
We're
be able to resist.
Arrange a temporary truce to allow the Dragonborn here to deal with the dragons, nothing more. I consider even talking to the Empire a generous gesture.
Are you done? Did you just come here to make speeches, or can we get down to business?
Yes, let's get this over with.
Are we ready to proceed? Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius. This council is unprecedented. We are gathered here at the Dragonborn's request. I ask that you all respect the spirit of High Hrothgar and do your best to begin the process of achieving a lasting peace in Skyrim. Who would like to open the negotiations?
Yes, let's get down to it. We want control of Markarth. That's our price for agreeing to a truce.
So that's why you're here, Ulfric?
You dare to insult the Greybeards by using this council to advance your own position?
Jarl Elisif.
General, this is outrageous. You can't be taking this demand seriously. I thought we were here to discuss a truce.
Elisif, I said I'd handle it. Ulfric, you can't seriously expect us to give up Murkarth at the negotiating table. You hope to gain in council what you've been unable to take in battle, is that it?
I'm sure Jarl Ulfric does not expect something for nothing.
Yes, that'd be entirely out of character.
What do you want in return?
Wait, General, you don't intend to just hand over Murkarth to that traitor?
This is how the Empire repays us for our loyalty?
Enough! First, let's be clear. This council wasn't my idea. I think it's a waste of time. You are a traitor to the Empire, and deserve a traitor's death. But I at least will negotiate in good faith. Since we're all here at your request, I'd like to hear what you think Murkarth is worth.
I don't know, what about Riften? Winterhold sounds like a fair trade. Riften's like nothing, but Winterhold has the Mage's College, doesn't it? I don't know, I feel like Riften, but then if I bring up Riften, I bet Delphine's gonna intervene in this conversation. What about Riften? I suppose we could give up Riften, right? Well, Riften's, I guess, technically annexed or whatever by Whiterun, so I don't know. Winterhold. Riften. I guess, let's talk about Riften first, I guess. Might as well. I'm like, it is a, I guess, technically as big as Winterhold, if you don't count the College of Winterhold, but what about Riften? I suppose we could talk about Riften, but then I'd take him, like, pretty much right next to, I don't know, what about Winterhold? If we give up Riften, we're basically giving up Whiterun, too, because it's, like, right there, but okay, what about Winterhold, then? Let's do Winterhold.
In exchange for Murkarth, the source of most of Skyrim silver. Hardly.
Oh.
Riften seems like a better choice to me. Well fortified, easily resupplied from across Lake Honric. Plus all the mead we can drink.
There are advantages to gaining Winterhold. Persuade. I don't know. Oh wait, no. He's going to get... Wait. I think I'm confused here. You're right, Riften is a fair trade for Murkarth. Oh, we give up Murkarth. Oh, okay, I was kind of confused there. We give up Murkarth in exchange for Riften. Or we give up Murkarth in exchange for... Winterhold, which has the Mage's College. Yeah, I guess, we can give up Riften for a... Yeah, let's do Riften.
I'm glad you agree. I was starting to wonder whose side you were on here.
Yeah, I was kind of confused there.
The Dragonborn has spoken, Talius. Murkarth will be ours. Now we'll see if there's anything behind your talk of good faith.
You disappoint me, Dragonborn. I accepted your invitation on trust in your good name. But it seems you intend to favor Ulfric. I can see now that this is not a negotiation at all. I know you, Ulfric. If I hand over Murkarth, you'll be ready with a new demand. You'll never defeat the Empire, and you know it. But you're willing to sacrifice thousands for your own selfish ambition. Soon enough, I'll have you back under the headsman's axe, and this time there won't be any dragon to save you.
As always, the Empire's fine words are worth nothing.
Stop! Are you so blind to our danger that you can't see past your petty disagreements? Here you sit arguing about nothing, while the fate of the land hangs in the balance.
Is he with you, Delphine? If so, I advise you to tell him to watch his tongue.
He is with me. And I advise you both to listen to what he has to say before you do anything rash.
Don't you understand the danger? Don't you understand what the return of the dragons means? Alduin has returned, the World Eater. Even now he devours the souls of your fallen comrades. He grows more powerful with every soldier slain in your pointless war. Can you not put aside your hatred for even one moment in the face of this mortal danger?
I don't know about the end of the world, but this dragon situation has gotten out of hand. If this truce will help the Dragonborn here put an end to that menace, we both gain. Remember that, Ulfric. Now, back to the matter at hand. You know as well as I do that we can't hand over Markarth on these terms.
You see what talking to them gets us?
Out with it, then.
We want compensation for the massacre at Carthwaisten.
You slaughtered the very people you claim to be fighting for. True sons of Skyrim would never do such things.
Damned Imperial lies. My men would never stoop to such methods, even in retaliation for your butchery at...
All the blood spilled in this war is on your head.
So, Dragonborn, what do you say?
Ulfric should compensate you for Carthwaisten. What's to say happened at
might as well, right? I don't even know what happened there. I don't remember why. I don't even know if it happened during the series or not. But Ulfric should compensate you for Carthwaisten. I suppose, might as well, right? I'm like, if we're giving up the biggest mining town in Skyrim, Markarth, for a Riften, I don't think that's a good enough trade. So yeah, let's say that he should compensate us.
Well said. For once you'll actually pay for your crimes. I suppose that's the fairest deal we're likely to get.
It seems we may have an agreement. Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, these are the terms currently on the table. Markarth will be handed over to Ulfric's forces, Jarl Igmund will step down, and Thangvor Silverblood will become the Jarl of Markarth. The Stormcloaks will withdraw from the Rift, allowing Imperial troops unhindered access. Jarl Leila Lawgiver will step down, and Maven Blackbriar will become the Jarl of Riften. The Stormcloaks will pay appropriate compensation for the massacre at Carthwaisten. You both agree to this?
The Sons of Skyrim will live up to their agreements, as long as the Imperials hold to theirs. What about you, Elisif? Are these terms to your liking? Speak up! I'm sure General Tullius is waiting to do your bidding.
I have nothing to say to that murderer. General, you've proven yourself a good friend to Skyrim. I continue to trust that you will do your utmost to safeguard our interests.
Thank you, Jarl Elisif. I appreciate your loyalty. The Empire can live with these terms, yes, for a temporary truce, until the dragon menace is dealt with. After that, Ulfric, there will be a reckoning. Count on it.
Come on, Galmar. We have a lot of work to do.
Giving up Markarth is a heavy price for this truce, Dragonborn. I hope it was worth it.
Jarl Balgruuf, I assume you are familiar with the Dragonborn's plan?
Yes, I'm ready to do my part. Just say the word, and my men will help you spring this trap.
But the difficulty remains, how to lure a dragon to Dragon's Reach at all?
Well, that's an excellent question. You haven't overlooked that little detail, have you?
Ah, I believe I can be of help here. I anticipated the problem. While you were arranging this meeting, I was busy in the library of Skyhaven Temp, an unguessed trove of lost lore. But the important thing is that the blades recorded many of the names of dragons they slew. Cross-referencing this with Delphine's map of dragon burial sites, I believe I've identified one of the dragons that Alduin has raised up.
How's that help us?
Don't you see? The names of dragons are always three words of power, shouts. By calling the dragon with a voice, he will hear you wherever he might be.
Why would he come when he's called?
He's not compelled to, but dragons are prideful by nature and loath to refuse a challenge. Your voice in particular is likely to intrigue this dragon after your victory over Alduin. I think it's very likely that he will be unable to resist investigating your call.
So what's the dragon's name?
Indeed. I'm no master of the voice, like these worthy gentlemen, but it is written here in this scroll. Oda Vin, Winged Snow Hunter, as I read it.
I hope this truce gives you what you need. It won't last. There's one more thing. We know about Parthenax.
You know what? Turns out he's a dragon, buddy. Help me.
Parthenax, the dragon that the Greybeards have been protecting for all these years. He needs to die. He deserves to die. And it falls to you to kill him. Until he's dead. Well, I'm sorry, but we would dishonor our oaths as blades if we continued to help you.
What do you have against Greybeards? About Parthenax? Yeah, let's do this about Parthenax thing. By the way, I must have gotten confused, because I was thinking of Riverwood instead of Riften. Riften is, of course, the town with Maven Blackbriar and the fishing and Thieves Guild and all that stuff. I was thinking about Riverwood. I was about to say, Riverwood's a piece of trash. There's really nothing there. Except for Delphine's little hotel and, I guess, a small logging town or something like that. And I don't know. It's been about a week or so since I've recorded, so I am just super off today. Anyways, about Parthenax, Delphine, what do you have to say about Parthenax?
Make your choice, Dragonborn. You're either with us or against us.
I don't know. Why does he need to die? Why do I need to casually kill the dragon?
Here's the big picture. He helped Alduin enslave our ancestors. He may have betrayed Alduin in the end, but that makes him worse, not better. We can't afford to give Parthenax the opportunity to betray us in turn and return to his old master.
But I'd say that the ends justify the means. But, I guess that's it for us, Delphine, for now. Unless I casually kill Parthenax. Alright, well, I guess we're done with this, so I suppose, I already learned that Odavine thing, right? The name of that dragon. Let me see if it's, is it here? Call dragon, there you go. Odavine, hear my voice and come forth. I summon you in my time of need. Alright, let's favor that bad boy. And I suppose we're going to head to, not River. God, was it called Whiterun? Jeez. See, I'm super off today. I guess we'll head to Whiterun, try and lure the Odavine person, trap him in the Dragon's Reach, try and be like, hey, where's this casual portal at, and all that stuff. Try and get it out of him, torture him, waterboard him and whatnot. Oh, there's Esbern right there. What do you have to say there, Esbern? You're just kind of hanging out.
Yes? What is it?
How can we lure a dragon to where's Alduin gone about Parthenax? Yeah, what do you have to say about the Parthenax thing?
Justice can be harsh, but it is still justice. Parthenax deserves to die.
Why does he need to die?
Parthenax was the author of many atrocities during the Dragon War. Crimes great enough to be remembered for thousands of years. True, he turned traitor to Alduin and helped overthrow the Dragon Cult, but that does not excuse or expiate his previous deeds. Whether or not he has truly repented or merely acted to save himself, justice demands that he pay with his life.
Okay.
Goodbye, then.
Goodbye, Esbern. I guess that's a decision for another day, huh? There's Delphine. What do you guys think I should do? Should I casually kill Parthenax, or should I let him live? I don't know. I don't really know too much about the story too much to really, like, make a decision right off the bat. Might need to learn a little bit more. Might need to talk to Parthenax about it, see what he has to say about me, you know, casually slitting his throat and murdering him and sucking in his soul like it's a big boatload of nothing. And, I guess I'll do that maybe next episode or something, because this episode's getting kind of long. So, thank you guys all very much for watching. If you guys enjoyed the video, be sure to let me know by leaving a like down below. And if you guys want more of these awesome videos, be sure to hit that subscribe button. I'll put my latest videos on YouTube homepage as soon as they come out, so you don't miss an episode. But until then, thank you guys all very much for watching, and I will see you guys here next time with some more Skyrim Remastered, where I guess we're going to lure one of those dragons into a Dragon's Reach and try and, you know, negotiate it and torture it and whatnot. So I'll see you guys here next time. Oh, bye there. You know, I'm really curious, actually. Like, what's going to happen if we run off this edge with a horse? Like, what's going to happen? Let's do it. Let's go, Skyrim horse. Oh my god, we're flying. Oh, and he's dead. Am I dead too? Is my Skyrim horse dead? No, I'm dead. Oh man, I'm going to break. Oh, boom, that totally broke my back. Am I still alive? Oh my god, I'm slipping. I'm still slipping down the... Oh my god, I'm falling off the mountain like it's nothing. Jeez. Oh man, I'm going to... Oh, there goes my foot. Oh, I'm dead. Oh, how is I still alive? I'm still alive right now. What? I'm tumbling down. Oh, yeah, I'm dead. Oh, that's pretty up there. Yo, I'm back. Anyways, thank you guys all very much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Oh, bye there.